not the crop of it.
I'm Sharon Caples McDougle, former Space Shuttle Crew Escape Equipment suit technician, crew chief, and manager. And people always ask, did you always want to work for the space program? No, I didn't know what I was going to do. My job chose me. I was very fortunate. A friend from the Air Force that I had worked with called and said they had an immediate opening to work with the space program, called this number. He had already spoke up for me and told him how great of a worker I was. With the astronauts, we were more invested with them because they would start training a year prior to launch. We're like their personal valets. We took care of everything. We helped them put on everything. We make sure they had everything they needed. They helped make it as easy as possible while they're here on Earth. So when they get to space, it's a piece of cake. Advice I would give to students, be you, always be your authentic self. I know they probably hear that all the time, but that's the perfect way to put it, be your authentic self. Also, if you have a career that you know you want to do, focus on that early as you can. I had no idea, so I was just very fortunate that things worked out. But if you know what you want to do, focus on that. And please remember that you can change your mind. You're not stuck, you're not married too. Well, even with marriage, you can change your mind, but you know. You're not stuck to that. Like you might've wanted to be a veterinarian in the second grade. You don't have to stick to that your whole time. You can change your mind. Grown-ups too. You don't have to stick to it. Don't be afraid to reach out to people. Professionals usually don't mind talking about what they do. Now with social media, man, you could just ask anybody. And pretty much like me, anybody reach out to me, I'm gonna talk their ear off. You want me to be your mentor? Okay. You don't know what you just signed up for. There's many jobs that don't require a college degree. Made it all the way to the top of my career. I was a manager the last 8 years of my department without a college degree. Hard work, perseverance, doing the right thing, showing up on time and showing out. Let them know you're in that room and you're there because you belong there. If you choose to go to college, that's great. I'm not knocking college at all. But there are many other options. You got to be able to communicate. I had so many astronauts tell me, I'm so glad you have a personality. A lot of people, for some reason, they'll be a little intimidated because it's an astronaut. I'm like, you're still a person. And so I would just be like, when I first meet them, hey, how you doing? Not like, sir, ma'am, you know, I just be myself. And so they really appreciated that. Teamwork is right up there too. So teamwork and communication. You have to have a team of people that can get this whole crew ready for a whole year before they launch. From the fit check all the way until landing. We are a team. It's not just one. Even though you may be assigned to one astronaut, you still have to work with that entire team. Teamwork goes on even when you don't realize teamwork is happening. We're all a team all the time. What does the National Air and Space Museum mean to me? It means not just my legacy, but everybody that's worked with the space program or in aviation will always have a beautiful home to come to. Our living legacies, it will always be alive. I mean, I saw the SR-71 then, right behind it, both of the birds that I worked with. Oh my God. It was overwhelming, it was. I just got all choked up. But it just brought back, just so many memories flooded back. Amazing.
Let us know what you thought of this video down in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. And follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.